the way I became a coach, I was 16 years old and my trainer opened up his second studio in North Hollywood. So I was 16 and there was maybe like 8 to 10 kids left in the gym. So he was more focused on the school in North Hollywood. We're in Glendale. And so a lot of the parents just wanted me to train their kids. And so my coach left it open for another year and he said, just, you know, you just take care of the classes and it's your gym. And you know, I actually did buy him off, and within like a few months we were up to like 50-60 students, because all the kids that trained with me, you know, I was like the leader of the class and I was always helping them out, and I was pretty much the best one on the team. So they just kept on coming. One, you know, word of mouth, they just knew I took over and they just kept coming. Well, I was born in Armenia. Growing up as a kid, you know, we loved playing soccer and watching Bruce Lee movies. We were fanatic, man. Everybody loved doing martial arts back home. And my uncles were in martial arts and in boxing. We had a family that were athletes. And so I just started from there and then moved to the States in 1989. I just wanted to be the best fighter in the world. And I did all kinds of competitions, Taekwondo competitions, Sancho fighting, boxing, and then when I was 16, you know, professional fights were like stand-up fighting for strikers was Muay Thai, so I started doing a lot of Muay Thai fights. I never thought I should be a trainer, it's just that I just fell in love with it. I started teaching some of the kids and they were doing good, and the parents, a lot of them just, you know, liked the way I taught them, and they just always supported me as a trainer. And when you're 16 years old, it's a bit tough on yourself, and you know, you're a kid yourself, and training a lot of kids and making sure all the parents do respect you, it's a lot of thought that you have to put into it. And everything is just intelligence, understanding, you know, you might not be the greatest fighter in the world, but you might be a great coach, and putting a structure together, putting a good plan together, and making sure that your fighter really understands that you're really putting the time and the effort into it. I'm blessed I could put a great plan together, you know, and make sure that I'm respectful. I'm always strict and I demand for them to do this and make sure that I bring the best out of them before it's time for them to fight and compete. What I request from my athletes is hard work, dedication, but understanding each other. Every athlete is different because the personality is different. It's about respect. If they respect me and they listen to me and they understand that I want the best for them, it's about just understanding the whole philosophy of it and just loving the sport, and I guess putting a lot of time and effort. I think work ethics, time and effort. Work and time, that's the meaning of martial arts, of kung fu, and I started off with that, you know, doing wushu, and it's just work and time, man. You put in the work and the time and the effort, you're gonna be good at it. For me as a trainer, as a coach, my quest has been to train elite athletes and have a lot of world champions. You know, my dream is always to have a lot of world champions and to train a lot of great champions, and you know, not one, not two, not 10. I want to have a lot of world champions, and I believe I can do it. And lately I just started fighting myself. You know, I was never a selfish person to just say, you know, I'm going to do it myself. And I got into teaching at a young age, but now I believe that I could do both, and I'm going to try to do both. You know, being a fighter, you have to be selfish a little bit at times, and it's hard for me to be that person to change my personality right away, because you're born, I guess, with a personality, and I have a personality of always helping people achieve their goals and their dreams. I help little kid students differently, and I help fighters that want to be the best in the world differently. So I just love what I do, and my quest is to just have a lot of world champions, and I'm gonna do that.